If you are indeed Christ, save yourself.
This
is the King of the Jews.
Also,
on this day,
it was the last day Jesus celebrated Passover. According to the book of Exodus, chapter number 12.
God told Moses that he wanted to destroy all the firstborns
in the household of the Egyptians.
He instructed Moses to tell the children of Israel
in each household,
they must go and slaughter a lamb, and eat it, and take the blood, and smear it on their
doorpost,
so that when the angel of destruction arrives and sees the blood,
it will pass over.
Is our food.
Since
yesterday, people were gathered celebrating the Passover. But I want to tell you this. Our Passover is the apostles.
It's on the 8th of May.
According to you, it is for you is to slaughter your heart.
For we
want that blood. That blood
will be in the form of a pen.
This is why in a pen.
When
you put that pen on paper, you shall be smearing
on
the doorpost the blood from your heart. When we speak of the bottom of paper, we speak of the
door
which through you enter the
house.
If you put your cross there, you are smearing blood on the doorpost. That is our Passover. This one is just a build-up season. The Father speaking of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. When you read from the book of John, Jesus said,
unless a man is born again, cannot see the kingdom of God.
Now the other man says, who cannot see
Jesus?
When he sees Jesus, he says, Jesus, the Son of David, have mercy upon me. He says, what shall I do?
For you?
He says, I want you to restore my sight.
Why the Lord Efuna Ubon?
Why does this man request?
Why the Lord Enum Tata?
Why this man is meant
to born
is to see?
It is because
the kingdom of God,
before
you can enter it,
we are born.
You have to see it.
Without
the eyes to see, you are in trouble. Now the apostle now says,
let
your kingdom come.
Let
your will be done.
It
is done in heaven. That means it has not yet arrived. When Jesus was speaking to his disciples,
in the book of Matthew chapter 3, verse number 2,
for the kingdom of God is at hand.
He said
to them, pray so that it may come. Now it is at hand. The problem that there was, that this kingdom was prayed for by men without sight. They went unto him one day.
inkosi
the lord
ubuntu buka thinto
this kingdom of god
buyofika nini
when shall it arrive
bethe kubo usonde
he says to them in the hand
but
he
will uzofika nini
they ask him
uthi madodo ubuntu buka thinto
the kingdom of god
buka phakathi kwe
it is within you
inkinga yakho
they are
abana wameso
see this kingdom
that is
why this man don't
try to say
and restore my sight.
Latin and Spanish.
And even us today,
Sikunwa,
we are saying the exact word.
When
I remember very well,
Ubaba, Uwazala, Ubaba,
the father who has given birth to
Father
David. His name is David.
David Parra.
David Parra.
When you
see our
father,
you see me, the son of the
when
I want to get on the podium, I
want
to say this word.
I'm
mad when the Father speaks.
John chapter 1.
John chapter 1.
In the beginning was the Word.
The
Word was with God.
The
Word was God. It became flesh. It doesn't say the Word dwelt in flesh. It says the Word became flesh. The Word became flesh.
As
you are a spirit, but you became flesh.
You. When you are hungry, it is not the flesh,
it's
your soul. But because this spirit is in, it is the flesh. Your soul, when it is in the flesh, it is the flesh.
For God became flesh.
Now, if God became flesh,
it means izinto.
It means things. Which we encounter. As the souls which are flesh. God is facing the same challenge. As the souls which have become
flesh.
You feel hunger.
Yes. In the
state
of the
state
that we call it, or
we do not know God completely. We know only in the front.
As a
human being.
Have the front part.
Have the back part. God is also the same.
The goats.
and put them on his left hand side.
And then take the sheep
and put them on his right
hand
side.
And he shall say to the sheep,
I was once hungry.
You
fed me. I was once without clothes.
You
clothed me. I was once thirsty. You gave me water.
In other words, God
can go hungry. Can go thirsty.
We are a man. God
can go without clothes.
God.
I shall
continue.
But in about is the book.
And the sheep shall say,
God, when did we do this?
God, when did we do this thing?
By the same bush, they have
done good unto him.
But they were not aware of what they have done.
So
they
become
a people of
things that they are doing them unto God.
What in her part?
He said, on the other hand,
what in me now?
He said, you.
I was once hungry.
They did not be.
You didn't give me food.
I
was once thirsty.
They won't be.
You didn't give me water. What was
the most
than I have?
When do we compare all these things to you, Father?
Now the question is,
who's
the lunch I love and bang bone with you?
How come these people did not see that this God?
It is because man
to
say who will be humble.
He gives them in reverse.
Abanazi.
And they don't know them. The truth is, all these people are in this world. In them, there is the Spirit of God. Everything that comes from God, it is God.
And
those people who are hungry, those people who are clotheless, who have no hope, who are sleeping, in the
because of no perfume or apparatus,
for the sake of this which is the
flesh,
that is God
who handles all our cat
boxes. It is God who is sleeping in cat boxes.
Now, the problem.
Now, the problem of
this problem.
Of this problem.
Who get a tool
are people who have
better for us.
In this word,
things are much more good.
I was trying to say,
Master,
let us abide by the ways which the Father has given us. From his mouth,
are pure voices.
Oh, there's no deception that comes.
Tell me,
he is trustworthy.
Posada, I can't wait.
Throw all your worries at him. For the Father's trustworthy.